Before I begin, find a really comfortable place to relax. A place where you won't be disturbed for the duration of this audio. This audio is not to be listened to whilst you're driving, operating machinery, or anywhere where you need to be alert. The perfect time to listen to it is in bed, whilst you're lying down, so you're comfortable and ready for sleep. There is no need to listen to the words too closely or analyze their meaning. Instead, allow the audio to play and allow your mind to wander and drift wherever it wants to. And as you listen to the sound of my voice, you're going to find yourself beginning to relax. To begin, allow yourself to settle into a really nice, comfortable position. And just slowly close your eyes. And now start taking some nice, slow, deep breaths. And start to concentrate on your breathing. Start to regulate your breathing so that you find a nice rhythm that is comfortable for you. And as you're taking those deep, regular breath, imagine that with each exhalation you're breathing out any tension, any worries, any cares from within your body. In fact, with each deep breath you're removing more and more stress from your body, and your mind is starting to slow right down. And as you focus more and more on your breathing, you may feel that you're starting to relax deeper and deeper. In fact, with every breath that you're taking, you're sinking down and feeling more comfortable, peaceful, and tranquil. You may feel a light or perhaps a heavy sensation. Whatever feelings you get in your body, they are the exact right ones for you. And as you go deeper and deeper, it may begin to feel as if you can feel yourself floating and drifting. Or perhaps being slowly rocked into a state of perfect peace and comfort. Notice how this relaxation is getting a little deeper with every breath that you take. And then begin to listen for any sounds that you can hear around you. These sounds aren't going to disturb you. In fact, each noise that you hear can help you to go deeper and deeper relaxed. In fact, you're going to find it interesting that as you listen to those sounds, you're able to control their volume simply by using the power of your mind. And firstly, you're going to allow those sounds to become louder, simply by imagining that you're turning a big volume dial up higher. And as the volume of those sounds starts to increase, you're going to be pleasantly surprised to find yourself sinking down, deeper and deeper, into a state of relaxation. In fact, you are now gaining control over that powerful subconscious mind of yours, which is going to be so helpful in making you relax and take back control. And now think how interesting it could be if you could make those sounds just become softer and softer, lower and lower, until they simply drift away out of your awareness. And once again, imagine that big dial now in your mind. And turn it down until those sounds simply begin to drift away out of your awareness. And as the noises start to fade away into the background, just focus on your breathing and notice how relaxed you feel. More relaxed, more peaceful than you felt in a long time. And as you're relaxing more and more, I want you to imagine that in front of you there is a lift. And there is a button for you to press to cool the lift. This is the lift that's going to take you deep down into your subconscious mind. I want you to imagine pressing the button to cool that lift. And as you do, the lift doors will open and you're going to step inside. Look around the lift and you're going to feel safe and comfortable. There is nothing to fear inside this place. Instead, you're going to feel relaxed and calm. I want you to look to the side of the lift door, and you're going to notice a series of buttons with numbers on them. And each of those numbers corresponds to a different floor in your mind. I want you to press level 1, and that corresponds to the floor that contains the deepest part of your subconscious. And as you do, the lift doors are going to close. And slowly the lift begins to move. And as it does, you're going to find that you're relaxing now, more and more with every floor as it starts to descend. And 10, the lift going deeper now into your subconscious, and your feelings of relaxation and tranquility are starting to increase. 9, you're beginning to let go of any stress and tension that's in your body. 8, you're feeling lighter and looser. 7, letting go of any negative feelings as the lift moves deeper and deeper down into your mind. 6, it's becoming more noticeable now that your mind is also beginning to relax and allow it to wander and drift to a place where it feels calm and peaceful. 5, you're realizing now that with each number and floor that you're descending, you're going 10 times deeper. 4, it's like a wave of relaxation is starting to spread. Starting at your head, it starts to descend down through your face, into your neck, your shoulders, spreading further down through your arms and into the tips of your fingers, and then continuing to move further down through your torso, into the tops of your thighs, and then descending down your legs into the knees, shins and calves, and all the way to the tips of your toes. And three, your body is starting to let go. And as it does, it's moving towards a state of peace and tranquility. And two, the lift is almost there. And you're going to feel yourself drifting and floating down now, further and further relaxed. And one, all the way relaxed, and the lift comes to a stop. And you feel instantly safe and cocooned in this place deep down in your mind. It's a place where only you can go and where nobody else can disturb you. It's your place of sanctuary. As the lift doors open, you're going to find yourself in a room with the most comfortable chair that you've ever seen in your life. I want you to go and sit in the chair and just relax. There is absolutely nothing that you need to be doing or nowhere that you need to be apart from just relaxing and exploring your subconscious mind. The messages and positive suggestions that you're going to experience today will help you to take back control of any anxiety, worrying, or negative thoughts which can make you feel as if they're taking over control of your life. Although you may consider worrying as a negative part of your mind or a destructive part of you, it is really trying to help you. At one point in your life, something happened to you that made you upset, embarrassed, or frightened. And a part of your mind registered that event as something it did not want to happen again. So from that point on, part of your mind became like your own personal bodyguard. It decided it would help you avoid at all costs something like that ever occurring again. It therefore began to plan and create all kinds of contingencies in case something bad or dangerous might happen to you. The funny thing is that in most instances, the issue that started off your problem may have been relatively minor. But because the incident may have happened when you were very young, that problem may have seemed very big to you. And because you became upset or frightened or embarrassed by that event, your subconscious took on the role of the bodyguard, which is now looking after you. That bodyguard creates plans every single day to make sure that this problem doesn't occur again. Now, of course, you may have completely forgotten the original problem or incident, but the bodyguard hasn't. And every day that part of you strategizes and checks every possible scenario in your life so that you can be kept away from what it perceives as danger or harm. The problem is that your bodyguard is no longer acting in a rational manner, which means now it perceives danger even when there is none. That means that even the smallest thing you do is thought of as a possible disaster scenario. This means that you may now feel frightened, worried, or anxious, thinking about the smallest task, even though there is no possible danger. So today I'm going to teach you techniques to take back control of that inner bodyguard, so that you can feel calmer, so that you feel more relaxed, and to change that old pattern of worrying and negative thinking into something much more positive for you. The first step in this process is teaching you to relax. When you're planning and plotting and worrying, your mind is irrational and it acts without considering the best possible options for you. By learning to relax, you're going to teach yourself to be calmer and to take control of your emotions. Just by practicing this self-hypnosis audio every single day, you'll start to feel calmer, more relaxed. But we're also going to talk about a number of other strategies that you can use to enhance this basic relaxation routine. So what is the first step in relaxing? Well, I want you to think about your breathing. When we're worried or anxious, our breathing and our thoughts appear to speed up. If you've ever suffered a panic attack, then you may have ended up hyperventilating. By slowing down your breathing and taking time out when you feel stressed or worried, you can increase your feelings of well-being. So start by taking a big deep breath in through your nose. Then I want you to breathe out for a count of 3 or 4 and do that nice and slowly. Then breathe in for the count of 3. And then when you breathe out for a count of 3 or 4, I want you to say the word relax in your mind. Spend the next 5 minutes either lying or sitting down and just slow breathing until you feel calmer and more peaceful. Practice this at least twice a day or at any time where you may feel under stress. This form of focused, relaxed breathing is the enemy of relaxation. The more you practice relaxing, the less likely it is that the anxious feelings will appear. Relaxation is the enemy of anxiety and worry. So do not discount this important part of your new daily routine. Then once you've taken control of your breathing, I want you to focus on your thoughts and simply start to calm them down by meditating on the words relax and calm. Keep on saying them in your mind until they become the mantra that you're going to live your life by. Relax and calm. By putting all your other worries and thoughts out of your mind, you're finding a place where you can allow yourself to think and where your outside worries or fears are many miles away. And now I want you to take a little time to attempt to trace where some of those worries are starting to come from. Some may be incredibly obvious to you, such as a stressful job, illness, or relationship issues. Sometimes you may not understand the root cause, in which case you need to accept that there are things at the back of your mind which are disturbing you, even if you are not aware of what they are. Be aware that our anxieties and worries tend to increase when our minds are not doing something creative. When you do something that you really love and are totally focused on the good things in life, there is no time to focus internally and worry. However, when we work in jobs that bore us and don't challenge us, or don't make us happy or fulfilled, we allow our internal doubts and thoughts to take over. Think about what you really want to do with your life. Think about what you really would like to achieve. And ask yourself what steps you can make to achieve that goal. Ask yourself if you're one of those people who are focusing on worries and fears when in fact there is nothing to worry about at all. For example, are you focusing on one negative aspect of your life without thinking about the huge amount of positives there are? Has your thinking entered into a state of imbalance? Do you jump to conclusions and often get things wrong? Do you catastrophize and think of the worst possible scenario when you know it can't possibly be true? If so, it's time to regain control and begin to reflect on what is actually happening in your life. Enhance your good, positive feelings and find time to exercise. It doesn't mean that you have to be at the gym every moment of the day. But by taking time to go for some walks, do a yoga class, you're finding time to breathe, to unwind, and to take time out from the busy stresses that are in your life. Anything which increases your feelings of well-being will enhance the process of self-hypnosis. If a negative thought or worry starts to appear in your mind, use distraction techniques so you can focus on something else. When we start an activity that absorbs us, our minds become so occupied with what we're doing that the worry begins to disappear away. This could be an activity as simple as baking a cake, talking with a friend on the phone, playing a computer game. It doesn't matter what the activity is, so long as it makes you happy. Mindfulness is another great tool to help you focus in the moment, instead of allowing your thoughts to run away from you. Anxiety is often a fear of something that hasn't even happened yet. That means that all of the disaster scenarios that are running through your head are not going to happen. Instead of being a Hollywood scriptwriter who is creating a disaster movie in your mind, you can halt your thoughts about future scenarios and simply concentrate on what's happening in the present. Focus on the small things in life that you often ignore. If it's a beautiful day, take time out to appreciate the sunshine. Admire the plants, the trees, sounds of the birds. Immerse yourself in what is happening now. And if you're doing what you would consider a mundane task, now focus on it more intently and concentrate on how you can make that task even better. External focus removes you from your internal worries. And if the worry refuses to go away, then start to allocate yourself a time to listen to that worry. You could take half an hour out of your day to do nothing else but focus on that worry. Spend time immersing yourself in the worst that can possibly happen. And then when the time is finished, put the worry away until the next day. This is so much more efficient than wasting all of your day thinking about it every now and then. Really focus on it, concentrate on it, and then let it go. Because no matter how much you worry, feel anxious, or try and plan for future events, nobody is able to plan for every eventuality. Rather than spending most of your life feeling bad because of worry, it's much simpler to wait before creating your response. The wonderful thing about humans is they have a fantastic way of responding to things as they arise. So if something does go wrong, you'll be reacting accordingly and giving the best possible response that you can at that moment. Spending 10 years worrying about an eventuality is not going to help you to deal with it in a better way. Imagine the scenario where there are two people. One who worries about everything, all the time, every single day. and the other who lives their life carefree and happy. If something comes along that disturbs their world, they will both find the best way to deal with whatever it is that comes their way. The only difference is that one of these people has wasted years of their life worrying about this eventuality to get the exact same end result as the person who never had a worry at all. From now on, you're going to think like a scientist. Instead of wasting time spending hours on thoughts that are not applicable, you're going to ask for evidence that your thought is correct or worth worrying about. Firstly, you're going to ask yourself, what evidence is there for your worried or anxious thought? So if you believe that the plane you're in is going to crash out of the sky, you need to ask yourself what a scientist would make of that thought. Of course, they would say that flying is the safest form of travel there is, much safer than going on a train or even a bus. Therefore, it seems that your mind is focusing on the one form of transport where actually there is the least danger. And that means it's being irrational. Now think about times when the negative thoughts you've been having simply haven't come true. For example, worrying about your children having problems at school. If you find they come home every day with a smile on their face and feeling great, then every time you experience that worry, it was a waste of time. Now imagine that your friend told you that they were having the exact same thoughts. What would you be telling them to reassure them that everything was okay? If you listened to their comments, would you believe everything they were saying was correct? Or would you reassure them that their thoughts had no basis in fact? You know you could help them to create a more rational and reasonable response rather than letting their mind come up with scenarios that simply weren't true. Remember that whatever comes along in your life, you will be able to cope with the situation. Whatever happens, you'll find a way of dealing with the problem. There is no point in trying to preempt the problem, as whatever you have in your mind is not happening to you now. And that is hugely important. Do you want to spend a lifetime worrying about things that are not true or that you're never likely to encounter? Become aware now that you have the resources to create new alternative ways of behaving which can help you more. Take back control. Teach your mind to relax. As the worries that are trying to make you feel anxious are really not relevant or important at all. And remember, every day that you practice relaxing like this, you are taking back control and feeling more confident and calm. With all this information in your mind, make your way back to the lift where you first came in. Press the button to take yourself back into your conscious mind and allow the lift to move. And 1, 2, 3, that lift moving up through the layers of your mind. 4, 5, 6, moving higher and higher. 7, on the count of 10, you'll open your eyes. You'll come back into the room feeling calm, peaceful, and relaxed. 8, 9, 10.